The mall at University Town Center in Sarasota, Florida. It opened this week. It's got every high-tech bell and whistle you could possibly imagine. You can see some pictures of it there. We have some footage. This is a modern U.S. mall, but it is only the third new construction mall to open since the recession. So for more on the state of retail, we're joined by William Taubman, the chief operating officer of Taubman Centers, which built that mall that you just saw. Were you down in Florida this week?
I was. I just got back.
So just, you know, tell us a little bit about this. A very big mall, right?
900,000 feet.
Yeah. Just tell me a little bit about it. What did you want to achieve with this?
Well, there was really a hole in the market because there was no great shopping center in Sarasota, which is about 1,200,000 people and 5 million tourists a year. Mm-hmm. So we saw a great opportunity to come in and really dominate the market, which is what we've done. We're over 90% leased. Great range of stores, everything from Crate and Barrel to Tory Burch to Rolex, et cetera.
To Tesla. I mean, you guys have a Tesla showroom, right?
In fact, I was standing with Terry Lundgren actually yesterday, and we were looking down at the front of Apple, and there were about, I don't know, 300-400 people waiting in line to get in. Mm-hmm. And so I turned to him and said, somebody forgot to tell all these people that brick and mortar is dead. And he said, well, somebody forgot to tell the 700 people waiting to get in my store this morning when we opened. So
that, you know, to me, that is the key question for you guys, because I look at myself in my own house. I have to say, like, you know, I don't mind going to the mall just to people watch and hang out and BS around and all this stuff. My wife hates it. She doesn't want to do that. She wants to buy things online. It is very easy for people to buy things online, and it is often cheaper. How do you guys respond to that?
Well, first of all, the businesses we're in are generally vertically integrated, so it's really not cheaper.
Meaning
J. Crew is J. Crew, whether you're online or in the store. You can't buy the merchandise somewhere else. So there isn't a price differential. It's not commodity goods. Yeah. We're dealing with fashion goods. Whether they're electronics at Apple or whether they're J. Crew jeans, they're still fashion goods in terms of the way they're sold. So that's number one. Number two, clearly people shop online. They research online. They come in the store. But I'll give you a statistic. At Restoration Hardware, they sell three times.
Is there one down there?
No, there isn't one down there. There's going to
be
one.
But we know it. It's a big
change, right. Sure. I'm just using an example. Right. They sell three times as much online when they have the goods available in the store to see in the market. So clearly the customer is coming in. Sometimes they're shopping online. Sometimes they're researching online. And they're coming in the store to buy. Mm-hmm. It is a seamless existence. And for instance, Macy's is the eighth largest online retailer in America. And yet it's got these almost 800 stores across America.
Right.
So I think at the end of the day, the world is evolving. The internet is changing everything about the way the world is operating. But it's not making brick and mortar obsolete. If anything, it's making brick and mortar more important, at least for those locations where the brand image is important and where you have a wide range of selling.
Right. And where, and we have to wrap it up here, but where, like this new mall, you basically have integrated the whole high-tech experience as much as possible into the mall.
No, we have all, you very soon. First of all, you can, very soon you'll be able to deliver right from the mall. Very soon, we do have full Wi-Fi, obviously, available.
Right.
And we're developing apps such that when the customer arrives, we'll know where she parked.
Yeah.
We'll be able to remind her where she parked. We'll be able to help guide her as to where she's going, et cetera.
All right, we have to leave it there, William. Thank you very much for coming in. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.